We looked at the top 2D Sonic games, but what about the 3D ones?
None of them are good. 3D clearly ruined Sonic. He should have stayed 2D.
Now. Okay, Sonic has had a bit of a rocky career when it comes to the 3D games, but there are some good ones in there. I promise. But which ones? Well, let's have a look at the top 5 3D Sonic games, but make sure to let me know what yours are in the comments below. If you like what you see, guys, make sure to hit that subscribe button at the end of the video. Still the best looking Sonic game to date, Sonic Unleashed, the first 3D boost game, more about going fast and less about platforming. Though there were platforming, the idea was to get good at reacting to certain jumps while maintaining the speed. I enjoy blazing through the day stages, traveling around the world, leading to some really cool and beautiful levels. The thing that drags it down is the night stages. Oh my god! This is almost as bad as the Sonic movie. The Werehog turns Sonic's gameplay into a more slower paced platformer slash brawler. Huh, where have I seen this before? Normally most people's least favourite thing about Sonic Unleashed, and the medals, shame about the frame rate as well. At least the music is good, the whole OST I'm in love with. Anything with jazz or saxophone has me hooked immediately. So when I come back to this game, I'm just playing the day stages. This seriously needs a PC release. Speaking of PC releases, Sonic Colors. Colors for you Americans. This game feels underrated. I partly blame the fact that it was on the Wii, returning to the boost formula but implements more 2D style sections, introducing the Wisps for some interesting power-ups and some great dialogue throughout the story. The music! Again, another amazing soundtrack, I can't stop listening to it! The only thing I would say is that maybe less of the 2D, and overall it's a short game. The bosses are kinda underwhelming as well. It's still one of the better 3D Sonic games though, and I wish more people could get the chance to play it. Before Mania, we had Generations, taking Sonic throughout history and erasing Sonic 06 for good. Oh. This is the best boost game in my opinion. They took Unleashed and refined the controls, giving Sonic a more tighter feel and improving his aerial movement. It's fun to play 3D versions of classic levels or revisiting previous levels from other 3D Sonic games. Speaking of classic though, Classic Sonic is also a playable character, giving 2D fans some love as well. I mean, I never would have thought to see Classic Sonic in Seaside Hill, and he actually controls pretty good as well. A combination of gameplays and a remix soundtrack. If anything, once again I'd say another fairly short game, but you do have the extra missions if you want more to do. Sonic Adventure 2, the game that introduced Shadow the Hedgehog. In other words, another Sonic-like character to play as. I mean, I'm not complaining, the speed levels are the best part of this game. The light dash is a simple button press. We have new abilities and grinding on rails. I also have a soft spot for the Chao Garden. The downside for me is kinda everything else. I'm not a big fan of the mechs. They're not terrible, but like, I'd rather play as Tails outside of the mech. The Emerald Hunter's dangers are, again, they're okay till you get to like Mad Space and Meteor Herd. The music is still fantastic though. Overall, it's a really solid game. I just prefer to go back to the Sonic and Shadow levels. Number 1. The adventure games may not have aged as well, but if any game were to get a remake, I feel like this would be the best choice. Sonic Adventure was the first transition into 3D, not including games like Sonic R, of course. And honestly, Sonic controls great. He's fast, as you'd expect. The spin dash makes a return and is overpowered as all heck. It's fun to make spin dash jumps to skip sections or reach places you never knew that you could. They introduced the homing attack, which soon became a staple for 3D Sonic games that lets you keep the speed and flow of the game. Tails also controlled just like you'd expect, but now he has a tail whip attack. This was the start of the Knuckles Emerald Hunt levels, which I don't mind so much in this game since the radar is better than SA2's. You even play as Amy, though she has a much slower paced gameplay, the levels aren't very long. Short, but sweet. E-102 Gamma is basically the mechs from SA2, but he moves a lot faster and I much prefer it. And then we have Big. We don't talk about Big. At least his levels aren't very long. And also, why is his music so epic? Speaking of the music, it's always a must listen. The levels are super fun. Okay, these games are a bit on the janky side in the modern day era, but what they had here with Sonic was pretty good. I wouldn't mind if they either remade this game or tried the adventure formula again, because it was honestly a lot of fun. You know the drill, guys, make sure to list your top 5 3D Sonic games in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and subscribe if you did enjoy, and I'll see you in the next video.